This is Andres with AA Construction LLC. I'm gonna give you guys a tour of the full development that we did here in Driftwood, Texas. Quick overview, we did a barndominium right behind me. Two container homes that were constructed with a third party but installed by us with the concrete piers and then actually installed on the concrete piers by us and along with the services. Then we have two storage units in the back. One of them is for personal use and one that has a laundry area. And then we're gonna give you guys a quick tour of the job site. Just a quick overview on these two units. So one thing that we did do is the concrete piers underneath here, as you can see. And then we also did the decks, 10 by 16 decks, stained and frame treated wood, treated decking, 1 by 6, 5/4 by 6. And we also did the metal roofs, VR panel, metal roof on there, so we can get a longer lifespan, 3 by 12 pitch, and that's pretty much it. So we did the same thing over here on the right side, 10 by 16 deck, along with the metal roof and everything. So we'll keep going. The other two small units that we did here as well were installed on the concrete piers here, and then we installed the services, as you see the little pipe sticking out. So these are 8 by 20, two containers. This one's for personal storage, one of which is gonna get used for a sound room for the clients. There's a piece of conduit that goes from here to here under the ground, and then they're gonna transfer cables from this section over to here. This right here is another 8 by 20 personal storage, and then this is gonna be your laundry area, which can give them a little quick tour of this. Over here on this side, we have the two AC units. This is the two condensing units, one here and then one over there. And then this is two mechanical rooms. Each one of them has an air handler. And then these are the items that you would typically find in the attic. So we made a mechanical room, and this is how we built it. We put the header there to support the roof up there. And it has the light and everything. Brand new air handler. And then these could be locked up with the key. All right, other air handler, mechanical room. This is the other condensing unit, and this is the other main panel. This main panel pulls from that transformer that's right behind there, and that transformer right there feeds all the units here. This main panel here that's under the barndominium feeds the two little storage units over there, and then this is the main sub panel for the barndominium. This right here comes from a media room that you will see inside the, you know, will go into each individual bedroom and certain areas upstairs that we have internet. It's gonna go through here, then it's gonna go to that media room, and then it's gonna go to the, you know, the individual rooms. Well house that we just built basically is an 11 by 14 foot, 9 foot ceiling on this side, 8 foot ceiling on that other side. Shed roof, low pitch. We're gonna do metal panel, roof, art panel. And then this is the interior tour of it. We use lap siding, 7-inch reveal texture, party panel, lap siding. This is a little water tank right here. So one thing that the client specifically asked for on this project is he wanted an emergency drain. The emergency drain is right here on the southeast corner, and then it comes out through here. So whenever there's an overflow, it's gonna pop out and then pop out, that's it. Goes out through here, and then right behind camera here, this is a drain. They're gonna have a salt treatment for the water, and this is gonna come out through here constantly. So they wanted it here away from everything so they don't kill the plants and trees and stuff like that. So that's just gonna disperse. And then we did a little complimentary little like step up patio here, or I guess path I should say. So inside here what you'll find is gonna be insulated with Rockwell R15 on the walls, and then we did R23 on the ceilings. Then we applied a 6 mil plastic over it, so then that way it keeps the insulation in place. The other thing too that we did a concrete pad inside there. We did left a little 4 foot by 4 foot gravel section with around the well head, and that way in case for whatever reason the well head needs to be drilled a little bit deeper, we could just take off one panel up on the top and then it could just go a little bit deeper. So that's pretty much it. Any questions, you guys can call us for your well house building. But now for the main course, this is the barndominium that we built right here in Driftwood. Welcome in. So this is a 30 by 50 barndominium. It has two bedrooms downstairs with individual closets. Upstairs, it has a loft slash office up above the bedrooms. On the other side, it has another loft, which is gonna basically be for like a living room area. Right in the middle, you'll have like a media room where they're gonna have a sound table with a bunch of, you know, controls and everything. That's gonna be, you know, getting some stuff from this other unit over here. So that's what the middle part's gonna be. On the left side, as you walk in, you'll see the kitchen slash dining room area with the little pantry underneath. And then on the right side, you'll have your main bathroom, your only bathroom, with the big walk-in shower and then a shower seat, glass panel. And then you have your little like media room underneath underneath one of the staircases further up north side of the building. And then overall, that's pretty much it. Basically, from start to finish, this whole development, we started in April of last year, and we're now officially completing everything with septic, water, sewer, electrical services, construction, the full construction of the whole, the coordination of it, a brand new well house that we just built, and then that's pretty much it. There's a lot of pros and cons for using a barndominium. The main pro that I would say is that get your biggest bang for your buck in terms of open square footage inside. You know, you'll see that you have really tall ceilings. The entire shell is fabricated with metal, and then the metal panels are all the way around. Metal panels lifespan is 40 years, so you don't have to worry about, you know, painting every 3 to 5 years. In terms of the energy efficiency, is way more energy efficient because we use closed cell spray foam, and then we use low E energy efficient windows all the way around. The other benefit to going with the barndominium is the price. For something like this, you know, we can get it as low as $185 per square foot, whereas if it was a custom home for the same square footage, you would get, you know, a little bit above $200 per square foot to be able to get the same finishes and the same look inside. Ultimately, the only con, in my opinion, from going with the barndominium would be the fact that you have metal panels, and a lot of people, that's a big no for them, is they want to have a more hardy traditional wood or stone. You can put stone on top of this to get that look. Obviously, you're gonna spend a little bit more for the, you know, for the aesthetics of it. At the end of the day, what you will see is that this basically looks like a regular house from the inside, and if that's okay with you, then barndominium would be a good option for you. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us, and we're, you know, family-owned, Aggie-owned, locally managed by us. Call us for your services and your future barndominium.